Welcome everyone. Today we're going to present you the dependence of the evolution of aurora displays on geomagnetic activity. In our study, we have utilized the Aviation Prime model, which uses energetic particle measurements from low Earth orbit satellites of the Defense Meteorological Satellite Program, considering four types of aurorae, and provides statistical distribution of aurora precipitation in the ionosphere. We have examined the distribution of aurora precipitation for three intense storms, one caused by a stream interaction region and two caused by coronal mass ejections. Let's turn to our first case, the geomagnetic storm caused by NSI at the 1st of June of 2013. On the left, we can see the diagram of statistical distribution of aurora precipitation, which are providing universal time, auroral kinetic energy flux of precipitating electrons and a geomagnetic latitude. On the right, we have the equatorial geomagnetic DST index with a time resolution of 1 hour, and then we move to the bottom right, on our summary diagram where all data have been correlated. Let's focus on the minimum value of DST in -124 nanotesla. We can talk about quite an intense geomagnetic storm at 9 universal time. The maximum energy flux is 9 watt per square meter at 6 RTUT, and the equatorial boundary for aurora is 58 degrees geomagnetic latitude, as we can measure from our Aviation Prime diagram with the maximum energy flux. Now let's move on to our second case, the next geomagnetic storm with similar intensity caused by CMEs between the 17th and 18th of March of 2013. Let's focus on the differences in our summary diagram. We have similar minimum DST value in -132 nanotesla to 2100 UT. The maximum energy flux is 14.71 watt per square meter at 1900 UT, and the equatorial boundary of aurora is 57 degrees geomagnetic latitude. To illustrate this point, we have to understand the differences between a geomagnetic storm caused by a stream interaction region and by coronal mass ejection, as we will right after our last case. Now we come to the geomagnetic storm caused by CMEs between the 17th and 18th of March of 2015. Let's focus again on our summary diagram. In our last case, we have a serious drop in our DST index in -222 nanotesla at 2300 UT. We can see the enhancement of the energy flux maximum in 16.5 watt per square meter at 1300 UT, and the equatorial boundary of aurora is 56 degrees geomagnetic latitude. So we have a more intense geomagnetic storm than the previous ones. Now we are ready to summarize briefly the conclusion of our results. Firstly, the reason for the difference during SI and CME storm is likely to arise from the nature of the interplanetary magnetic field, IMF. During CMEs, there is usually a large persistent southward turning of the IMF, accompanied by high solar wind speed. This enhances magnetic reconnection on the day side, which adds open magnetic flux into the Earth's magnetotails and transfer energy to the system. The explosive reconnection events in the tail known as magnetospheric substorms, which inject energetic particles into the inner magnetosphere and cause the precipitation that produces dynamic aurora displays. In comparison, NSI do not have extended periods of southward IMF, and so the rate of day side reconnection is much smaller. That's why our second case is more intense than the first one. Moreover, we have to consider the approximately 2 hours delay between the maximum energy flux and the minimum value of the DST index. So what does this mean? During the geomagnetic storm, we have injection of energetic particles from the magnetotail to the inner magnetosphere. This injection is enhanced by magnetospheric substorms. Particle acceleration occurs by the repolarization of the magnetic field and by intensive electric fields. Particles with small pitch angles are reaching the polar cusp and they form aurora displays. For the drop of DST index, time is needed in order for the drift motion of energetic particles to enhance their ring currents. So this delay is confirmed with our knowledge of the energetic particles in the magnetosphere. To emphasize on the factor of magnetospheric substorm, we used the Aurora Electrojet Index AL as a measure of magnetospheric substorm activity. We have collected data in 15 minutes intervals, and for this reason we used the CMH index, a geomagnetic index with 1 minute resolution. For instance, we can see in our summary diagram that right after the drop of the AL index in -2094 at 1645 UT, we have the drop of the CMH index and the enhancement of the energy flux. Aurora displays are the only optical manifestation of space weather in space, in geospace. The spatiotemporal evolution of aurora borealis exhibits a bewildering but repeatable variety of complex structure and dynamics, which is correlated with solar activity and could become an essential part of space weather prediction models. That's why we believe that it's very important to delve into this study. Thank you for your time.